Hey, what's up, lovers? Welcome to JSON Programming Tutorial Number 5. In this lesson, you will learn how to make a dynamic JSON AJAX PHP-driven photo gallery that you can tweak and enhance to make it your own. The application will dynamically render any amount of images from any folder that you point the application to, and it can easily be made to render multiple photo albums, which we will demonstrate in Tutorial Number 6 for you. This is the finished product of what you will be creating within this lesson. We'll be using the JSON data handling skills demonstrated in the previous lessons to create this photo gallery from scratch. And it's all dynamically driven. Any folder that you point it to, no matter what images are in it, they'll come flying out into your image gallery as little thumbnails, and when the user clicks on the little thumbnails, the corresponding image gets placed into the photo frame on the right. And the user can scroll down through all the images to the very last one. See? And it's very intelligently programmed. In order to create this dynamic photo gallery, we're going to continue with the same exact files that we left off with in tutorial number 4. So let's take json-tutorial4.html file, save as json-tutorial5.html. Save. And you can close tutorial 4. Now let's take myjsonlist.php that we had from lesson 4. Let's go to file, save as, and let's name this json underscore gallery underscore data. Save. So that you should have JSON underscore gallery underscore data dot PHP sitting there. And you can close my JSON list dot PHP. So now you have your new files ready to go. First, we're going to tweak the JSON tutorial 5.html page. Now let's change the name of this function from AJAX get JSON to AJAX JSON gallery. So you can copy that and make sure you put it down here. Now we're going to send one parameter through this function, AJAX JSON gallery. That parameter is going to be for the folder of the images that we want to scoop up dynamically and put in. And I have a folder called Gallery 1. And I'll show you Gallery 1 right now. You see here in my JSON test folder, I have all of the JSON tutorials we've been going through since tutorial 1. And here's the Gallery 1 folder. If I double click on that, you'll see I have a bunch of JPEG images in there. So now you know what Gallery 1 is referring to. It's that folder. It's going to be sitting on my web server. So since I'm passing a parameter through that function, it has to be scooped up here when the function runs. So let's put folder as the variable name that will be created for whatever value is passed through here to there. And we want to make that value available in the hrsend method. So we're going to send a value of, instead of two variables, we're just going to send one variable of the folder name that we want. So in the PHP script, it's going to be looking for a posted variable of folder, and we can put the value for that right here, which is folder. It's going to be this dynamic variable passed through the function when it's called. And when it's called, you pass it through using single quotes right there, which is the folder name that you want to grab. Huh? What do you mean? Now, down in the HTML of your page, instead of div results, we're going to replace div results with three divs. And that is all of the HTML content that you're going to have within the body element of your page. Just those three lines. So you want to have three divs, one with an ID of page top, the next one ID of thumbnail box, and the next an ID of picture frame. So here, this was the page top div. This is the thumbnail box div, this whole vertical box here that's tucked up against the left side of the page. And this is the picture frame div. You can see the picture frame div is fixed in place and it does not scroll. Alright, so that's your HTML markup. Now we're going to go above the script tag here and we're going to put in some CSS, and I'll explain that to you very quickly. We affect the body element of the page to give it margin 0 pixels, background of black, whatever color you want, and the color of the text. Now here, this CSS rule affects the page top div, this CSS rule affects the thumbnail box div, and so on and so forth. So you can see that my CSS is set up to affect certain elements within the page. Now thumbnail box is going to contain divs, and inside of each little div you're going to have a thumbnail, and you can clearly see that on the page. The big gray vertical box is the thumbnail box, and each thumbnail within that box is really a div, and within that div is an image, which is the thumbnail. So that's why you see this CSS. It's digging into thumbnail box, affecting the div and then the image within the div. And this CSS rule affects the actual div that holds the image. All right. So you'll have to know basic CSS to understand what I have going on there, but it's pretty basic stuff. It's nothing very complicated at all. The tricky part of what we're going to be doing is really on the PHP side of things and what we do when we get that data back right here. Now let's go into this Ajax JSON Gallery function and let's change what we need to here. This needs to be JSON underscore gallery underscore data, because that is our new file, which is a PHP script that's going to do the magical digging out, dynamic digging out of images out of any folder. You won't have to know how many images or what their names are prior to the script running. It'll just dig them out. And that's the kind of script that we're going to make in PHP. But it's going to be returning JSON encoded data. So all of this stays the same, except when we get down to var data, I'm just going to change that to D. So just keep in your head that D now represents data. And since we have no results div, we have to change that to thumbnail box. So right up here, results at the top, change that to thumbnail box, is equal to document.getElementById thumbnail box. And then down here, inside of the ready state if condition, when the data returns, we put thumbnail box.innerHTML equals nothing. We clear it before we're going to populate the thumbnail box with all the little thumbnail images. It's basically the same thing that we did in the last tutorial, where we cleared the box before new data was populated. So in the for loop that we have for the data, we're going to change that to D. Remember, because the data variable doesn't exist anymore, I just changed that to D. Change that to D, and change this variable name to O. So just remember that O means object and D means data. Let's inside of that for loop, erase those two lines that are there. And within the for loop, you're going to place this if condition. If the variable object within data, if its .source property is present. So this if condition will return true if there's a .source property for the data object coming through. It will return false if there's no source property for the data object passing through the loop. So you're just saying if there is a source attribute or a source property for the data object passing through the loop, then you're going to stick it into the thumbnail box using the inner HTML property, and we're going to say plus equal to append to the data within that box. If you say just equals, each one will overwrite the ones that were put in before. So you say plus equal, and they'll just all keep compounding into the box. A bunch of little divs, and with an image tag inside of each one. So remember when I was telling you, you're going to have divs with an image tag inside for each one of these thumbnails, and that's how we're getting that there. We're packing a div, and inside of that div, there's an image tag right there that has the source attribute for the source property of the data object coming through. And I'm going to show you in the PHP script how we send the source file for that image through the JSON data objects. Now all we need is a function called putInFrame. So you can go under your Ajax JSON gallery function at the very bottom and put in this function here called function putInFrame. And you can see function putInFrame is fired off on the onClick event of that div. So if you go into the gallery and you look, see how it, the thumb, when I click it, that is when that event fires off, that function. So when I click each one of these divs, that is when that event fires off, this function called putInFrame. So what you're doing is sending the source of this photo, whichever photo is being clicked on, whichever thumbnail, you're sending that source through this function called putInFrame. So here's that variable called source. So you can easily say pictureFrame.getElementById, pictureFrame, and then you say pictureFrame.innerHTML, and you load in to the picture frame, the main frame on the page, the image source tag. So each time it's being replaced by the new image in this big frame here. When I click a little thumb, or really when I click one of these little divs that holds the thumb, the main source image is placed into the main frame here on the page. So really, outside of your for loop, you really should load in the first image in the gallery into the frame by default, which you can see that's how mine works. When the page loads, this first image was loaded into the frame by default. Nobody had to click anything to make it be there. So you have to program that in. So where we have thumbnail box, let's go ahead right under that and put in picture frame. That way we have a reference right here for the picture frame element down here on the page. Now right here under your data object and before your for loop begins, you can put a line that will be picture frame.innerHTML is equal to, and then you just pop in an HTML image tag with the source of the data objects, image one object dot source property. And you're going to see the format of the JSON data that our little PHP script is going to render in just a minute. And you'll see we have image 1 through 14 being set up dynamically, and they'll each have a source property that you can tap right into. So you can use image 1's.source to put the first picture into the picture frame by default when the application loads. That's what this line is doing right here. Now, we've got a couple of more things to change. Right here where it says results, that div doesn't exist anymore. Now we have thumbnail box. And that's where we want to place a little fan loader, or you can even place a fan loader into your picture frame box if you want to let the user know in that area visually that something's loading. Or you can just load something into the vertical thumbnail box on the left that is an image, a .gif fan loader, some kind of animated image, or you can just have the words requesting sitting there like I have it, because that word requesting will be replaced by all of the image thumbnails when they come pouring in. Now, the very last thing we need is, since this Ajax JSON gallery function is going to fire off right away for the default gallery to be loaded in right when the page loads, we can put some inner HTML into this page top div up here in the JavaScript. We'll just do that the first line. We'll say document.getElementById page top.innerHTML, and we'll put this inside of it. So that way, like you see on the page here, it will say this up in that page top div. Or if you want, you can just write it right in there. But I wanted to keep the HTML very light and streamlined within this video lesson. That way you can see how to manipulate everything just through your JavaScript. And I'm pretty sure that's all we need. If there's something I forgot or whatever, after we get the PHP file written, we'll just go ahead and quickly change it up to make it so. So basically, this is going to be your PHP script that is capable of rendering all the dynamics that your gallery is going to require. And if you go to developphp.com, years ago, in the PHP and MySQL video tutorial section, there's Discover Magic XML, and we pretty much showed the same exact thing right here, Flash Photo Gallery app, PHP loop, dynamically render files. So here's that PHP loop that dynamically goes into any folder that you want, that you specify, and grabs all the image files out of it. I just went and grabbed this script and adapted it for our needs in JSON, okay? That's all I did. So that's what you see here at play. Now I'm going to explain every line to you so people who are new to this kind of thing can follow along as well. And what we'll do is we'll actually render this file without depending on this Ajax function to make it run. At first, we'll just run this page in the browser just to see what it renders. Okay, so the first line is you scoop up the posted variable from the Ajax request that was folder. And that is sent through the Ajax request in the send method right here. Folder is equal to folder, whatever the dynamic gallery is. In our case, it's gallery 1. So really, this will have a value of gallery 1 in my case. Then we start our JSON data object rendering. Just we're setting up the string to render as JSON. And we just put the opening curly brace, and that's all we put for now. Then we specify the directory variable, and that's going to be equal to whatever this dynamic folder value was with a forward slash after it. So pretty much that directory value will be gallery1/. Then you set up a directory handle using the opendir function in PHP, which opens a directory for reading it, and you feed it whichever path to whichever folder that you want to open up for reading. So now you have a directory handle object ready to go. Then we create the I, which is the iteration variable, and set it to 0. And that's going to be incremented using I++ through our little while loop here. And our while loop reads while file, which is the variable name for each independent file that's read inside of the directory. So within your while loop, you can target that object or that file, say it's a JPEG or maybe it's a text file. You can target that file using that variable, because that variable is created right here. Now let's see, what does this if condition say? This if condition says if the file is not a directory and if the file has a .jpg extension. So only if it is not a directory and if it only has a JPEG extension are we going to scoop it out and make an object out of it for our image gallery. Because if it's a .txt file in that folder, you don't want to scoop it out and put it in the gallery. That's what this string position function is doing. It's looking to see that the file has a .jpg extension. Then and only then will it be packed into our little object. And you also want to make sure that it's not a folder. So within that folder full of images, you might even have another subfolder. You don't want to scoop that thing out and process it either. So that's what this if condition takes care of. So if it's not a folder, and if it is in fact a JPEG, then we're going to scoop it out and make it part of our JSON data object. So we I++ to make this 0 increment each time the loop passes through all of the different files within the folder dynamically, because we just want to keep a count. So the first file, since we increment before anything happens, this will be a 1. Okay, so what we're doing here in this variable for source is we're putting together the dir variable and the file variable. So basically you're just saying gallery1/unknownfile.jpg. That's what it'll look like. This source will look like that. And that's what you're going to be feeding into your gallery. That's how your gallery knows what images to plop into the image tags. Now here we simply set up our JSON data variable to compound. Remember we started it up here with just the opening curly brace to establish that it's a JSON data object. Now within that JSON data object, we're going to be packing a whole bunch of more deeply nested objects. And each object is going to have a property of image whatever I is dynamically. So it'll be image 1 on the first pass of the loop. Image 2 will be the second file. Image 3. So they'll each have that property. And on the right side of your colon, which is the value for those properties, you're going to have another little nested object. So each image has three properties here. We have num, source, and the name. Num is just a variable that I wanted to throw into the mix. You really don't even need that property for this image gallery to run. So the first image that passes through the loop, it'll have a value for its num property of 1. Its source will be whatever the image is dynamically for the first image being accessed. And its file name can be packed in here. And actually, my application doesn't even use this variable or this property. Really, I'm only using the source property, but I threw these others in here. So if you guys wanted to have extra information come through in your objects, you can do that. And you just have to make sure that each file, each image file, each JPEG that's being accessed through the loop has a comma put on the end of each inner object. And then after the loop, you want to just make sure that you close your directory handle, and then you chop the last comma, because remember, there can be no trailing comma on the last deeply nested object. Only on the objects before the last one do you have a comma. So you just make sure you use the chop function, and then that will remove the last comma off of that string. And then as a final measure, you compound into that variable, JSON data variable, the closing curly brace. So here you open your curly brace, and here you close your curly brace. In between those two curly braces, you have a for loop. It's going to magically pop in a whole bunch of images into JSON data format. Now I want you to test this script without being passed any posted variables from your HTML file. So what we can do is just comment this line out, press Control C, then one line down, let's press folder, put the name of the folder that you want to access for your gallery. Now FTP JSON gallery data.php up to your live web server and navigate to that script and run it. Okay, I'm gonna go and in my address bar, You see, I have JSON gallery data.php. I'm going to press enter. See, I have JSON data objects. And you can see the last one has no comma. The rest have commas in between all of them. And the last has no comma because we used chop. You can see the last image is number 14. It's image 14 is its property, and its value is another nested object which holds all the information for that image number 14. Its source file, you see, and each one is the same way, and it's all rendered dynamically. Now, all you have left to do, since you have a good visual feel for what this script is going to render to your application, let's go ahead and remove this static variable that we had here. Let's make it dynamic again by letting our HTML application post the folder variable to this. And remember, we have it being posted here in the send method for our AJAX request. And make sure that when you put this variable back in play, you press Control S and FTP this file, this PHP file, FTP that as well, and your JSON tutorial5.html. So on your live web server, in your address bar, type in JSON_tutorial_5.html and booyah, baby. This is all dynamic goodness. And you can easily have multiple galleries in here. Let's say you wanted to have a list over here of links that were for different galleries to load into this bad boy. Right when you click those different links, a whole new gallery of thumbnails and everything will be loaded right into the page without refresh. And if you guys want to see something like that, just let me know and I'll put it in tutorial number 6 to show how to extend this image gallery to make it do other cool new things, like be a multiple album image display gallery. Since we're already feeding the dynamics right here through the function for the gallery folder, it would be very easy to make some links power which folder that is. So I hope that gives you guys a better look at the power of JSON. JSON is not its own scripting language. It's just a way to get data from point A to point B universally and effectively. And the power behind it is going to be that a lot of people are going to be learning it. You can really do the same things that I'm doing here with custom strings. I've done all the same things that I'm doing here using custom strings. You don't need XML, and you don't particularly need JSON to do any complex things that we're doing with this kind of work. Where they do come in handy is that a lot of developers are using them. That way, if I make a gallery here, pass it along to the next guy, he's going to understand the data transfer, the data interchange between the server and the application. He'll say, oh, that's JavaScript object notation. I can totally work with that. So that's why it's handy to learn these kind of things.